Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain TV. The Deputy Prime Minister, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, hosted a luncheon today in honor of Viktor Zubkov, the Russian special presidential representative and chairman of Gazprom Board of Directors, who is visiting Bahrain to participate in the Bahrain International Air Show. Prior to the luncheon, a meeting was held during which various areas of cooperation between the two countries was discussed, particularly with regard to oil and gas. Present were the Foreign Minister Sheikh Khaled bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa and Minister of Energy Dr. Abdel Hussein bin Ali Mirza. The second day of the Bahrain International Air Show 2016 saw thrilling flying displays from some of the world's most remarkable aerobatic display teams. Thousands of spectators looked on as a packed flying display program unfolded with performances from the likes of the UAE's Al Fursan display team, the UK's Breitling Wingwalkers, and the Saudi Hawks. Held under the patronage of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the unique and commercially focused environment of the three-day Bahrain International Air Show at Sakhir Air Base is said to be a success, with a significant number of returning and new participants. With a high level of international and regional attendance, the air show provides an opportunity to showcase Bahrain's unparalleled regional connectivity as a major logistics hub. The global event reflects Bahrain's outstanding status as a hub for hosting different landmark events and conferences, as Bahrain is keen on keeping abreast of latest aerospace and technological strides. The massive participation of world-class aircraft companies also reflects growing interest in the aerospace industry. Sakhir Air Base was once again a hive of activity as people gathered to witness some of the best aerial displays in the world. Paul Fraser has more in this report.
The second day of the Bahrain International Air Show 2016 saw what could be record visitor numbers to the Sakhir Air Base. I found out just what people thought of this year's air show.
I'm too glad the 3 days, every people here, they are interested to come. The air show, and especially I came every 2 years here, and I see the old people, they are interested at that air show. Every single place in the corner of the world, they know Bahrain now, step by step, by the air show and the F1. And I'm very excited to come here and invite my friend with me, and thanks Bahrain for the air show.
With bouncy castles, food stalls, a motion capsule ride, and much more, coupled with the aerobatics of Mark Jeffries, the DHL Twisters, the high-speed thrills of the Saudi Hawks and the Typhoon Eurofighter, to Al Fursan and the Sarang helicopter display team, it really has been an action-packed day.
I'm Nate. Looking forward to seeing the Bahraini F-16s out here at the air show today. Learned a lot about Bahraini culture with the Heritage Village and talking to the folks around here, and we're just enjoying the good weather and the aerial demonstrations.
Hi, I'm Ragar. I've just been bull riding and it was really cool. And I'm really looking forward to seeing the Saudi hawks because they're just like the red arrows. And also I'm really looking forward to going to a cool playground that we can all play at.
Today's show finished with a spectacular pyrotechnic display performed by the Twisters. And tomorrow is, of course, your last chance to catch all the thrills and all the action. From Sakhir Air Base on the second day of Bahrain International Air Show 2016, this is Paul Fraser for Bahrain Television.
In light of major trade deals going on at the Bahrain Air Show, entertaining sideshows and fun activities left all visitors at Bahrain Air Show filled with joy. More details in this report. The Bahrain Air Show took off on its second day of fabulous air displays and amazing tours of the exterior and interior of end-of-the-line commercial airplanes. But aviation sector traders weren't the only ones entertaining. The instructors of Gravity, the world's biggest indoor air tunnel here in Bahrain, are providing tips on their kind of flying.
During the World War II, there was action in this part of the world, and the Bahrainis actually purchased 6 Spitfires for the Royal Air Force to operate from the island, and they were used to defend the skies of Bahrain in the Second World War. Well, they bought them for the Royal Air Force back then, but that has then evolved to become the military that there is in Bahrain today.
Not only the public had their fun, but traders were able to try out the Typhoon simulator as well as hearing an interesting history lesson of the 200-year-old British-Bahraini relations and how the Spitfire fits in.
We're here today just to promote the new sport of indoor skydiving and try to kind of educate and get people interested. And it's from children right up to 100 years old. So it's available for everybody. There are no real limitations. And we're just trying to spread the word and let everybody know that Bahrain now has the world's tallest wind tunnel, and so, which is quite unique. It's all glass from the ground to the ceiling, and it's the only one of its kind at the moment in the world. So Bahrain's got something to be very proud of.
The air show is open to the public for yet another day, filled with great entertainment. This is Sarah Brake for Bahrain 55.